Elizabeth Rojas, Paulina Calixto, Jenny Rico, Arlette Perez, and Kimberly Rojas requested this hashtag, hashtag recreated Laura Tagle. Yay, CreArtists! How are you? Welcome! Don't forget that today is hashtag recreated Laura Tagle, and today's design is super wild that I almost have no idea where to start, but here goes. So, check it out. The first thing we've got to do is sculpt some stiletto nails. You can sculpt them with acrylic or with gel. I made them with gel this time. It's a gel that I've become quite fond of, so if you'd like to know the brand, please leave your comments and I promise I'll show you which one it is and give you some tips in the next video class, okay? Okay, cool. So once our stiletto tips are done, what we are going to do next is the top part. We are going to apply pastel pink semi-permanent gel on two nails only. Next, we seal them with our finishing gel and all set. We're done with these two for now. So moving on to another nail. Now for this one, we are going to use black semi-permanent gel. So apply two coats, but right after we apply the second coat, we'll take advantage of the fact that it's a little bit gooey to apply some metallic pigment powder, or like I did since I didn't have any powder. I used these metallic acrylics in copper and gold, and since I used very little of it, there was no issues whatsoever. So I applied it, put a little bit of pressure on it with my finger, and sealed it with finishing gel, and that's it. So our third nail is ready so we can move along with our design. Now on our pinky finger, we are going to apply a pink glitter. Oh my god, it's so beautiful! But to make sure that the glitter sticks, we are going to need a little bit of gel. So you can use the base gel that you normally use in your semi-permanent system, or like I'm doing right here, I'm using the sculpting gel I used for the tips. So it's a bit thicker, but for this design, it actually works quite ideally because it'll make the glitter stick better to the nail. Okay, so once you have an even coat on the nail, we are going to sprinkle this glitter onto it. This is metallic pink, which looks absolutely gorgeous, and we are going to do it with a spoon of our cuticle pusher. Yeah, I mean, you can also just dip your finger into the glitter, but it's really not too hygienic, so just stick to the spoon. So, we apply a little bit of pressure to the glitter so it really sticks, we cure and all set. Our nails are nice and red. Now, here comes the Rubik's Cube of our design, which would be the eyeshadow palette. I used a hinge from a picture frame, but you can easily get one at any hardware store in your neighborhood. Okay, so we are going to use a very small hinge and cover it with black matte acrylic. We are going to grab a large side bead. My recommendation is that you make sure that the acrylic is nice and even. So before it dries out, we are going to stick these squared studs on, and you are going to place them upside down. It doesn't really matter what color they are because, you know, they'll be upside down. This is to create the effect of the eyeshadow pans. Okay, so make sure to place them on as quick as possible before the acrylic dries, because if not, you'll have to glue them on with resin and it's a lot more complicated. Now for the lid. We are going to use the same black matte acrylic, nice and even, and after this, do the same thing for the outer part of the palette. Okay, so make sure to avoid the part of the hinge that moves or else you won't be able to sort of, you know, like open and close it. Okay, once the acrylic is dried, we are going to file it with a very soft nail file so that the acrylic doesn't come off, since we didn't really use that much. This is just to even it out and all done. Let's see it with finishing gel so it looks nice and shiny and done. And here's our eyeshadow palette that opens and closes perfectly. Now for the eyeshadow part, we are going to scrape a little bit of eyeshadow that you might have and mix that in with a little bit of gel. It can either be a base coat or a finishing gel, and then we are going to pour that into the mini eyeshadow containers of our palette. We cure and it's done. Now in the mirror part, you can use a hologram paper, or I decided to use some aluminum foil and I'm using nail resin to glue it on. So that would be all for our eyeshadow palette. Now let's do the brush. What we'll need is a toothpick that we can cut, and we'll also need an old paintbrush to cut some of the bristles off and use them. So we cover the toothpick with semi-permanent black gel, and right after applying the second coat, we are going to glue the bristles onto it. Cure it, put some tinfoil on it, and add a coat of finishing gel. Okay, so once our artifacts are ready, let's glue them onto our nails. So we are going to adhere them with clear acrylic or crystal acrylic, and with a good side bead, they should not fall off at all. I think that this design isn't actually ideal to have on our nails on a daily basis. I think it might be more for like, you know, like a show. Unless you choose otherwise, well, then I don't see a problem with it. And because, you know, these things won't fall off whatsoever. Alright creators, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you think I overcame this challenge as expected, give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to share this crazy video with your friends, and I'll see you next Thursday for our video class. Remember, I love you tons. Bye!